Welcome back. Now that we have translated our physical system into a hydraulic model, we need to insert the different parameters into the different hydraulic components. To do this correctly, I advise that we always ask ourselves what it is we are trying to calculate. Let's assume that we are trying to calculate the valve position needed to ensure a flow rate of 300 cubic meters per hour. Thus, I will start by inserting the parameters in the valve component as it serves as the bottleneck component in our model at the moment. I do so by selecting the valve in the model, and in the property window, we need to choose a characteristic type by pressing on the small arrow on the right. We see that we have different options. In case we are provided with a characteristic by the valve manufacturer, we can insert it accordingly in KV, CV, or XII format. However, for the purpose of this exercise, we will choose a standard characteristic. Automatically, we are getting a butterfly type of valve. However, it's important to note that we have other options. Similarly, if we press this small little arrow on the right, we can choose a gate valve as well, or a ball valve as well. So we move on and we fill in an inner diameter of 250 millimeters. And instead of having the position as the initial setting of the valve, we choose a discharge because we want to ensure an initial discharge through the valve of 300 cubic meters per hour. Now that we have filled the information for the valve, we move on to the reservoir, which has a water level of 20 meters mean sea level. Accordingly, we fill in the initial head 20 meters. We have a steel pipe which has an inner diameter of 250 millimeters and a wall roughness of 0.1 and a length of 1000 meters. We can also insert 1 kilometer and press enter. By doing so, Wanda will automatically convert kilometer to meter because the unit setting of Wanda at the moment is meters. Now we have the storage tank, which is found at elevation of 0. It has an initial water level of 1 meter. So that is the initial head. We put it 1. And its surface area varies according to the height. So we choose an area type variable instead of constant, and we fill in the table that the area at height 0 equals to 10, and at height 10 it equals 50 square meter. Now we need to run the model in steady state in order to find the answer to our question. We will do this in the next video.